The Bruin LMG is extremely versatile, and if you make this build, you're probably going to go on some good streaks. The recoil is super low, and it's way more mobile than most LMGs in the game. Plus, you get to feel like the Winter Soldier for just a little bit. The Gunsmith has been one of the coolest additions to Call of Duty. I mean, just period, all time. It not only allows for tons of weapon customization, but it helps you tailor fit just about any gun in the game to fit all type of different roles. But what about the most iconic, the signature guns from other franchises? What if we pulled them into modern warfare? Ever since the game came out, people have been trying to recreate tons of guns in the Gunsmith. And today, what's up everybody, Chaos here. I'm gonna bring you 10 of my favorites that you may have not seen yet. I dug super deep for some of these, so hopefully you learned something new, and some of them are really fun to mess around with, so I'll be sure to include the exact blueprints as well. You let me know in the comments which iconic signature gun you like the most, or if you want us to do another one of these, drop a like, and here we go. I see a ton of you are watching and enjoying the content on the channel, but you're not subscribed. Take a second, hit that sub button, turn on those notifications, and let's get the Team Chaos subscriber percentage up into the 30s. Starting things off is Arnold's M16 from Predator. Now, this is an awesome assault rifle from the 1987 classic Predator. Throughout the movie, Arnold Schwarzenegger is seen with a custom M16 assault rifle. Now, to make Arnold's M16 in Modern Warfare, you need to start off with the M4A1 assault rifle. Then, throw on the stock M16 grenade barrel, the M16 stock, and the 40mm high explosive underbarrel grenade launcher, otherwise known as the U2. Now, it's a pretty mobile build, and you've still got the power of the M4 at your fingertips with a couple extra attachment slots if you want to use maybe an optic or a perk. And then you've got the grenade launcher, which looks really cool, but it's actually pretty awful because the grenade launchers in this game suck, but it doesn't matter, okay? It's a pretty cool build, and it's a good starting point for a pretty tough M4. Next up is Agent 47's double pistols. The Hitman games let you use a ton of different guns and weapons to take out your target. But one of the most reoccurring weapons in Agent 47's arsenal are the akimbo silenced M1911s. These actually make for a pretty decent stealth class in Modern Warfare, and it's worth checking out the coolness factor as well. You start with the 1911, you throw on the monolithic suppressor, the 45 match grade barrel, the heavy duty trigger, the stipple grip tape, and of course, the akimbo perk. If you use these alongside perks like Ghost, Cold-Blooded, and Tracker, well, you can make a pretty awesome stealth class, and in hardcore modes, the 1911 is a 1-2 shot kill, so you can actually feel like Agent 47 himself running around the battlefield. Now, I wouldn't recommend this class in Warzone, but in normal multiplayer, it's pretty decent. At number 8, Ash's Boomstick from Army of Darkness. Now, Ash uses a variety of improvised weapons throughout the Evil Dead series, but in the third movie, Army of Darkness, Ash gives his trust shotgun a name, the Boomstick. Now, to make Ash's Boomstick, you start with the 7.25 shotgun, of course, and then you throw a choke on the muzzle, the Tempest 32-inch competition barrel, the Tempest sport stock, and then slug rounds just for good measure. And sure, the 7.25, it's not as good as it used to be, but it's still pretty fun to mess around with. The slug rounds are optional, and I don't think Ash would mind if you took them off, because the slug rounds in the game are pretty crap, but it's still a cool gun. The 7.25 may be annoying, but it's super satisfying to run up, get a one-shot with this massive boomstick of a shotgun. You can't have an iconic or signature weapon without Dirty Harry's Revolver. It's simple, but it's awesome. Dirty Harry's Revolver is one of the most iconic handguns in movie history. Now, in reality, it's a Smith & Wesson Model 29, but in Modern Warfare, you can get pretty close to it with the 357 revolver as a starting point. All you have to do just throw on the stipple grip tape and the 357 long barrel, and boom, you've got Clint Eastwood's weapon of choice. Now, you'll have plenty of extra room to throw on other attachments if you want to speed things up, but it's a great starting point. Plus, if you combo it with other primary weapons on this list for a little extra spice, you could have some fun. Next up is Han Solo's blaster from Star Wars, and you've probably seen a few different Star Wars builds in Modern Warfare, but here's one that I think maybe, possibly, you haven't seen. It's definitely the weirdest gun on the list, but it's worth goofing around with. I did my best to recreate Han Solo's blaster from episode 4 and 5, and this is what I have. You start with the Renetti handgun, then you throw on the muzzle brake, the MK1 extended barrel, the XRK speed grip, and the XRK 4.0 pistol scope. I know, it looks terrible, but when you put it side by side with Han's blaster, I think it's actually pretty close. And in hardcore, you may be able to cheese some kills out of it. Maybe, I don't know, you tell me yes or no, but I think it's pretty close, visually at least. At number 5, Carl's AUG from Die Hard. You know, a lot of you probably don't even remember this gun. If you do, you're much more cultured than the ones that don't, probably. There are some awesome guns in this movie, and one of the most recognizable is Carl Steyr Auk. Carl is the right-hand man of the main villain, and Bruce Willis faces off with him a couple times. And to make Carl's Auk, you have to do quite a bit of a conversion. You start with the AUG submachine gun, you throw on the muzzle brake, the 6.22 long barrel, the Integral 3.0 optic, the F-TAC ultralight hollow, and then you convert the ammo to a 5.56 NATO 30-round mag. Die Hard is an awesome movie filled with awesome guns. And the AUG, I mean the AUG that's in it, is freaking awesome. I mean, throw this one together, mess around with it a little bit, especially when next Christmas season comes around, because yes, everybody, Die Hard is a Christmas movie. At number 4. Bucky's LMG from Infinity War. Now, Bucky uses a few different guns throughout the MCU, but I was able to come up with a pretty close recreation of the one he uses in the Battle of Wakanda in Infinity War. You start off with the Bruin MK9 light machine gun, throw on the XRK Horizon 23-inch barrel, the tactical foregrip, the 60-round mag, the Integral hybrid, and then the FSS close quarter stock. Everybody knows the Bruin LMG is extremely versatile, and if you make this build, you're probably going to go on some good streaks. The recoil is super low, and it's way more mobile than most LMGs in the game. Plus, you get to feel like the Winter Soldier for just a little bit. Give it a go. At number 3, the EVA 8 from Apex Legends. Now, this one may not be as iconic as the others on the list, but it's still really good, and it translates very well. The EVA 8 is one of the shotguns available in Apex Legends, and you can make a pretty accurate version of it right here. You start with the Origin 12 shotgun. Throw on the lightweight suppressor, the 25-round drum mag, and the F-TAC hunter stock. Plus, you have two additional attachment slots to do whatever you want after that. Plus, you've got a huge 25-round mag instead of the 8-rounder that you have in Apex Legends. I know it doesn't behave like the EVA 8 shotgun, but it looks a heck of a lot like it, and it's equally as fun to run around and spam people out with it. Just know that if you're the person with an Origin on hardcore shipment, you're a bad person. At number 2, John Wayne's rifle from just a whole lot of movies. John Wayne had a handful of rifles that he used in a lot of his iconic Western films, one of them being the Winchester 92. Now, obviously, you can't make it perfectly in Modern Warfare, but we can get close. You start with the MK2 carbine, and then you throw on the FSS 18-inch factory barrel and the MK2 ultralight hollow stock. It's going to give you a foundation of an iconic rifle, but also with a little wiggle room for perks and grips. This build may not look exactly like Duke's rifle, but if you think of it as a modernization of the Winchester 92, it's actually pretty good. It does raise the question, though. Would you guys want to see a Wild West Call of Duty game ever in the future? There were a ton of awesome rifles, shotguns, and handguns from that era. I know it would be different, but it would potentially be awesome as well. And at number 1 today, the Black Ops 1 FAMAS. I know, I'm cheating, but I'm going to do it. I mean, it's awesome gun. Plus, with a new Call of Duty game right around the corner, allegedly set during the Cold War, there's a good chance we'll be seeing this bad boy again. To make the Black Ops 1 FAMAS, you start with the FR-556 assault rifle. Throw on a compensator on the muzzle, the Forged Tac ultralight barrel, the Stipple grip tape, and the FR ultralight hollow stock. And I know the gun would still be a 3-round burst, but it looks much closer to the iconic Black Ops 1 FAMAS. Plus, there is an extra attachment slot open for an optic if you choose it. If we do end up getting the Black Ops reboot this year, I really, really hope that we get a FAMAS that looks as awesome as this one, preferably full auto as opposed to burst, but that's just my choice. You guys, let me know what you think. If you enjoyed this, if you want us to do another rendition of this in the future, we could probably do it. What is your favorite out of this group? I have to probably go, I don't know. I'm kind of leaning toward Han Solo's blaster personally, or maybe Bucky's LMG. You guys, let me know what you think, and I'll see you soon.